though school is out, we have VBS coming up next month. It is not too late to sign up. Ask your parents to register you and a friend. And also, happy Father's Day!
Now on to today's Bible story. Do you remember how God kept his promise to Abraham and Sarah? They had a baby boy named Isaac and they were very happy. They loved Isaac so much and they loved worshiping God. In Abraham's time, one of the ways people worshiped God was by making sacrifices to the one true God. To make a sacrifice, people would kill and burn a specially chosen animal on a pile of rocks called an altar. God does not want his people to do this today because Jesus became the sacrifice for sin once and for all. After Isaac had grown into a young man, God decided to test Abraham's faith in him. Abraham was the only person in all of history whom God tested in this way. This is not a test God will ask you to do. Say it with me. God provided the Savior. God spoke to Abraham. Take your son, your only son whom you love, Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on a mountain I will show you. God told Abraham to offer his son Isaac as a burnt offering. Did God really want Abraham to give up his precious son's life on an altar? No. God was testing Abraham's faith. God never, ever wants anyone to sacrifice another person. People are very special because God made them in his image. Abraham knew this. Abraham knew the character of God, what God is like. He knew that God is holy and God is love. Abraham also knew of God's promise to bless the nations of the entire world through his family, starting with Isaac. So the Bible tells us that Abraham's knowledge of God and faith in him was so strong that he knew Isaac would live. Abraham didn't know how, but because Abraham knew God so well, he knew God was going to keep his promise and save Isaac's life. He could trust God to do something to rescue Isaac. He knew God was faithful and always does what is right. And so Abraham was willing to obey. The next morning, Abraham woke Isaac and told him they were going to the mountains of Moriah to make a sacrifice to God. They quickly prepared for their 3-day trip. The trip was long and tiring as they walked along the way. And finally, on the 3rd day, Abraham looked up and saw the mountains of Moriah ahead of them. Abraham said to his servants, "Wait here with the donkey. Isaac and I will go over that mountain and worship, and then we will come back here to you." Did you just catch what Abraham said? He said, "We will come back." You see, Abraham trusted God was going to rescue Isaac and that both of them would be coming back safely. Abraham had complete trust in his faithful God. Now, so Abraham took the wood and tied it on Isaac's back for him to carry. And as Abraham and Isaac walked together up the mountainside, Isaac noticed something was missing.
"Father?"
"Yes, my son."
"Where is the lamb for the sacrifice?"
"God will provide a lamb for a burnt offering."
Why did a lamb have to die? In the Old Testament days, God gave his people some laws or rules to live by. Some of those laws said that God's people needed to offer sacrifices. The sacrifice was never supposed to be a person. Some sacrifices were to show how awful sin is and that the payment for sin is death. And God wanted his people to know how serious sin is. He required them to offer sacrifices where a lamb or other animal would die in their place. As Abraham and Isaac reached the top of the mountain, Abraham built an altar. When the last stone was in place, he took the wood and laid it on top. He tied Isaac and put him on the altar. The time had come to make the sacrifice. But suddenly, at the last moment, Abraham heard a voice. "Abraham! Abraham!" It was the angel of the Lord. Abraham answered, "Here I am." Then the angel said, "Do not lay a hand on the boy. Do not do anything to him. Now I know that you fear God because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son." Abraham has shown his amazing faith. He had passed the test. God never intended for Isaac to be sacrificed. Remember, people are valuable to God, and he loves all people. He loved Abraham and Isaac, So just then, Abraham turned and saw a ram caught in a thorn bush by its horns. God had provided the animal for the sacrifice. Abraham and Isaac must have worshiped God with grateful hearts as they sacrificed the ram. Why did God ask Abraham to sacrifice Isaac? You see, God wanted to show us a picture of what the Savior would do about 2,000 years later. The Savior, our Jesus, would be a sacrifice for you and me, dying in our place, just as a ram was a sacrifice for Isaac. After Abraham and Isaac lived, people offered sacrifices for sin for thousands of years. Many lambs died, but the blood of all the lambs that were sacrificed couldn't completely forgive the sins of the people. The lambs reminded Abraham's family that one day a Savior would come who would pay for sin once and for all. Isaac was saved by the substitute God had provided, but now Isaac would someday have children of his own just as God had promised. He would be the next patriarch of the family. Abraham named this special place Jehovah Jireh, which means the Lord will provide. Before they left the mountain to return to the waiting servants, the angel of the Lord spoke to Abraham again, reminding him of God's promises. Abraham had trusted and obeyed Jehovah Jireh, the loving God who provides a way for sin to be forgiven.